Hello friends, in this video I'll give you the formula list of penalty method handling a boundary condition, and I'll solve one problem on a penalty method.
Formula list for penalty method. Addition to the previous list, these are the four formulas you have to add. Penalty value will find C is equals to maximum Kij into 10 to the power of 4 Newton per millimeter. Then this value we need to add for a first row first column and nth row nth column. Rest of the remains same. Similarly, for a force vector we need to add here for a first force and nth force, with C into penalty value into displacement at the node number 1 we need to add, and nth node value displacement at node number n we need to add. Where the fixed ends are there, we need to add the penalty value. Where C is in a penalty value, A1, A2, An is equals to Q1, Q2, Qn displacement at the nodes. Reaction force, slightly equation will get changed. You can see that reaction force is equals to Ri is equals to minus C Qi Ai. We need to remember this one, very important. So this example, if node 1 is fixed, I is equals to 1, then this equation becomes R1 minus C Q1 A1, where Q1 is a calculated value by using penalty method, A1 is in a given in a problem. The value, maybe it is equals to 0 or some value will be given in a problem. We know that idea. And then normal force vector F is equals to F1 plus CA1. F2 remains same, F3 remains same, and nth node value Fn plus CAn. Force vector will take for penalty method type of a handling boundary condition. This is a formula list which we need to remember.
Now we'll solve the problem after getting the idea of about penalty formulation and the procedure. Read the question. Using penalty method of handling boundary condition, determine the nodal displacement stress in each element and support reaction in the bar shown in figure. Due to applied force P is equals to 100 kN, take E steel, Young's modulus is equals to 200 GPa, Young's modulus E copper Cu is equals to 100 GPa. This is in a given bar element representing along x-axis from left towards the right direction.
Numbers of nodes, how many nodes are there? 1, 2, and 3. 3 nodes we have. Force is applied at node number 2, that is in the same direction, which is a positive force, that is equals to 100 kN. 100 kN is equals to 10 to the power of 5 Newton.
Bar has made up of two material. First step, a steel material. Second step, made up of a copper material. Has a diameter 60 mm of a steel element, 40 mm of copper element. A length of a steel element has 800 mm and length of a copper element has a 500 mm. And load applied mid node of the bar element, that is 1, 2 and 3 nodes we have. Based on the change of geometry, we are representing the node name. We'll say a steel element as element number 1. Due to the direction of representation of a bar from left towards right, start solving the problem from left towards right direction. Element number 2 for copper element, length L1 800, L2 500, D1 60 mm and 40 mm after representating the elements. We have given the name of the dimensions. An Young's modulus of the steel is given as a even copper element E2. Now we'll take the data, and then as per the instruction of the given problem, we will represent the FE model, first step of finite element method. what he has given in a problem using penalty method handling boundary condition. We need to use the penalty method, right? Then he has applied a load at mid of the element 100 kilonewton, that is 100 kilonewton, P is equals to, that is equals to 100 into 10 to the power of 3 newton, converted simplified value 10 to the power of 5 newton. Young's modulus E, I have told, E steel E1, 200 gigapascal is given, converting that gigapascal in terms of a newton per millimeter square. 200 gigapascal is equals to 2 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per millimeter square. Copper element Young's modulus E2 is equals to 100 gigapascal, that is equals to 10 to the power of 5 newton per millimeter square. A diameter of the steel is given, a 60 mm. We know that K is equals to A E divided by L into 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. We need to find this area of cross section to find this. We'll convert that value in terms of a A1 and A2. So now I'll convert this diameter in terms of a A. A1 is equals to pi by 4 d square. Steel material has a 60 mm. Substitute that value 60 square. The calculated value of the area of cross section A1 is equals to 2827.43 millimeter square. Similarly, a diameter of the element number 2, copper, has a diameter 40 mm, that area A2 is equals to pi by 4 dcu square, that is equals to pi by 4 40 square. Calculated value of the area number 2 is equals to 1256.63 millimeter square. And force at node number 1 is equals to 0. We have force at node number 1 is equals to 0. Force at node number 2 is equals to 10 kilonewton. Force at node number 3 is equals to 0. Length L1 is equals to 800. L2 is equals to 500. Then what we have to find here in a given problem? We need to find the nodal displacement, stress in each element, and support reaction. To find in a given problem nodal displacement, Q is equals to question mark, stress in each element sigma E is equals to question mark, supporting reaction at each node R is equals to question mark. Solution: we know that a finite element method, first step, FE model, we need to create. We have a stepped bar element. This stepped bar element has fixed at both ends, and the load has been applied here. So it has a node number 1, 2 and 3. Node number 1, node number 2 and node number 3. Node number 1 has a force F1, displacement Q1. Node number 2 has a F2, displacement Q2. Node number 3 has a F3, displacement Q3. And the length of the element number 1, L1, length of the element number 2, L2. So direction of a bar as representing along x-axis from left towards right direction. So this is the FE model. We are well known how to represent that one. After representing that FE model, we know that second step of finite element method, elemental stiffness matrix. We have derived this stiffness matrix by using direct and energy method. That is equals to KE is equals to AEE divided by LE. 1 minus 1 minus 1 1. We have our two elements, E is equals to 1 and 2, I is equals to 1 and 2 3 we'll take, but we'll take only a 1 and 2 utilization of this I 3. Just we are representing, we have a 3 nodes. So while we'll find the stress, now consider element number 1, E becomes E1, this K E becomes K1, A E E E, L E becomes A1, L1, E1. As it is, take down this one, this one, 1. So substitute the value of A1, E1 divided by L1. Area of cross section for element number 1, a steel material, 2827.43 mm. Young's modulus for steel material, 2 into 10 to the power of 5 newton per millimeter square. Length of the element number 1, 800 mm. So all the values you substitute here. In this equation, area of cross section, Young's modulus, length of the element, then calculate the value of this will be equals to 7.685 into 10 to the power of 5, 1 minus 1
minus 1, 1 as it is. We have taken 10 to the 5 taken common, and this value has multiplied inside the matrix. We got this matrix. After getting that matrix, we need to give the matrix column and row names based on the element is present with respect to nodes. Element number 1 starts from node number 1 and ends at node number 2. So the characteristics of a node number 1, column number 1 and row number 1. The characteristic of a node number 2 is column number 2. Characteristics of a node number 2, row number 2. Why we have a 2 cross 2 matrix? Each node has a 1 degree of freedom. That means first row, first column name has a 1, second row, second column name 2. If you have a more than 1 in node number 1 itself, multiple numbers of row and column will have. Okay, so based on the degrees of freedom we are representing, we know that complete idea. Now we'll find the stiffness matrix for element number 2, E2. When we'll take element number 2, E is equals to 2, generalized equation is yields to 2, K2, A2, E2, L2, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1. Then substitute the value of A2, E2 divided by L2. We know that from given data, calculated value of the area of cross section for element number 2, copper, 1256.83 millimeter square. And Young's modulus is equals to 10 to the power of 5 newton per millimeter square, 100 gigapascal is given. So the length of the element 2 is equals to 500 mm. All the values you substitute here in the given equation and then calculate this value. That value is equals to 2.5133 into 10 to the power of 5. 1 minus 1 minus 1, 1. 10 to the power of 5, you take down common. 2.5133 multiply inside the matrix, we get this matrix 2.5133 minus 2.5133 minus 2.5133 plus 2.5133. The element lies between the two nodes, which is element number 2. Element number 2 starts from node number 2 and ends at node number 3. That means first row, first column name with respect to node 2 and 2. Second row, second column name 3 and 3 with respect to node number 3, where the element number 2 is lies between the node number 2 and 3. After finding the elemental stiffness matrix, we know that step number 3 of a finite element method is a global stiffness matrix. The global stiffness matrix for a stepped bar, we have two steps, K1 plus K2. Each node has a 1 degrees of freedom, 3 nodes. That means 3 nodes into 1 degrees of freedom is equals to 3. We'll get a 3 cross 3 matrix. Now I'll copy that all the characteristics of a K1 and a K2 we have found here. K1 value, similarly K2 value we got both represent here. I have substituted that values here, K1 and K2. Then I'll get the global stiffness matrix for a given element. The global stiffness matrix I'll rearrange is equals to 10 to the power of 5. I'll take common here. Now 3 cross 3 matrix we'll get that is here 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I'll give a row name and column name. After giving that row name and column name, I need to get the value of first row, first column name. I'll search row number 1 first. Where it is there in the elemental stiffness matrix, in the first element. Row we have, we don't have any row here. First row starts from 2 and ends at 3. We'll get start from 1 and ends at 2. We want a first row, first column, first row, second column, first row, third column. Now I'll get a first value of this first row, first column. So we have here first row with a first column. This is the answer for a first row, first column. First row, first column 7.0685. Then first row, second column, we have a first row, second column. First row, second column value is this. You can see this is equals to minus 7.0685. Similarly, second row, third column.
second row third column we don't have, that is equals to 0 with respect to this, but here we have a column, we don't have the row, that is a mismatching the row and column. That means there is a no value of a first row third column is equals to 0. Now we'll consider a second row first column, second row second column, second row third column. Then I'll find the second row first column value. To find this one, where are the rows are there, find out it first. Here we have a second row in a elemental stiffness matrix, and here also we have a second row. So second row first column we have here, second row first column value. Similarly here we don't have any second row first column is here. So that means second row first column in the second matrix is equals to 0, and here we have the value that is equals to -7.0685. so we can take that value, -7.0685. now we need to take a second row second column value, this one second row second column. We have a second row second column here, similarly we have a second row second column here. Add these two values, we'll get a second row second column. So second row second column is equals to 7.068 plus 2.533. after this second row third column, this value here, we don't have any third column. Let's check it here in this next matrix, second row third column we have. So then second row third column -2.5133, I have taken here -2.5133, second row third column. Similarly we need to go with the next, we got a two rows, now we need to concentrate on a third row. Third row we don't have here in this matrix, we have a third row here. Third row first column, we don't have any first row value. Third row first row column is equals to 0. Third row second column, we have this one, third row second column -2.5133. similarly third row third column here, third row third column we have 2.5133 we have taken from here. So we have got a global stiffness matrix from the elemental stiffness matrix. Now find a global displacement vector. So global displacement vector Q is equals to Q1 at node number 1, Q2 at node number 2, Q3 at node number 3. Why? We have a stepped bar element with a two step. Here we have a displacement at node number 1, Q1, here at node number 2, Q2, at node number 2, Q2, at node number 3, Q3. So we can check out here. In a FE model, node number 1 Q1 displacement, node number 2 Q2 displacement, node number 3 Q3 displacement. That means displacement vector has a 3 displacement. We got the displacement vector, global force vector. How many forces we have? 3 forces at node number 1. Similarly, a force F1 at node number 2, F2 at node number 3, F3. We have the force applied at node number 2 is positive due to the direction of force is applied along the x-axis with respect to the representation of a bar is same direction. So now we have F1 is equals to 0 due to fixed at node number 1, and F2 has been applied 10 to the power of 5 newton. Then node number 3 is also fixed, that is equals to 0. Then we got a global stiffness matrix, global displacement vector, we got a global force vector. After getting that global characteristics of a given bar element, now we need to represent that all value in terms of equilibrium condition, that is step number 4 of a finite element method. Substitute the value of the global stiffness matrix K, Q and F, global vector of a given problem. Till here it is remains same as per the previous problem what we have solved by using elimination method. After this we will apply the boundary condition. When whatever type of a problem you take down till step number 4, it remains same. Then after getting a equilibrium equation, we'll apply the boundary condition. From here, all types of a problem will get changed based on the type of boundary conditions we are handling given in a problem. Now we have a boundary conditions are q1 is equals to q3 is equals to 0 due to fixed at node number 1 and node number 3 using a penalty method handling a boundary condition. What is the first step of a penalty method? Means we need to find out the penalty value of the given problem. That penalty value of the given problem C is equals to the maximum value of a stiffness matrix into 10^4. When we'll multiply 10^4 value to a maximum value present in a stiffness matrix, we need to identify here in a stiffness matrix which is the maximum value in a global stiffness matrix. This is equals to Kij, means I means row, J means column. So which row, which column it's available, here we need to search. So when we'll check out in this matrix, we have a maximum value is equals to 9.5818. So that means K22 value is equals to maximum value, and it is multiplied with the outside value 10^5. Its unit is Newton per millimeter. We have this maximum value from the stiffness matrix. Multiply for this value 10^4 is equals to penalty value. We need to search the highest value of our stiffness matrix and multiply the 10^4, will get a penalty value. This penalty value is added to the K119, K33. We know that the idea. So now we have that penalty value, the maximum value of a Kij from the matrix. We have K22 is equals to 9.581 into 10^5 Newton per millimeter. And then we have the penalty value is equals to 9.818 into 10^5 into 10^4. Then this simplified value in terms of a 10^5. This 10^4 I will multiply for this is equals to 95818 into 10^5 Newton per millimeter. This penalty value added to the stiffness matrix K11 and K33. Why it is fixed? This one first row, first column value will add, last row, last column value will add in the formula explanation and procedure explanation I have explained, and also I have explained that complete steps involved in penalty method, right? So due to fixed K11 is equals to in a matrix 7.0685 into 10^5. Here the value what we have, this value into 5, this value becomes a what, K11 plus C. That value is equals to 7.6085 into 10^5 plus this penalty value. Then that K11 becomes K11 plus C, which is equals to 10^5 into 95825.0685 Newton per millimeter. Similarly, last row, last column value becomes K33 plus C is equals to 2.5133 into 10^5. So this value what we have, K33 last value 2.5133 into 10^5 plus of this penalty value, which is equals to 95818 into 10^5. So add these two values, we'll get that addition of these two value is equals to 10^5 into 95820.513 Newton per millimeter. These two values substitute in a matrix, this one K11 and K33, rest of the values are remain same, only the first and last value will get changed, this as it is will be there. So now what we have, a global force vector. Force also will get changed. We know that I have told for first row, sorry, for first node where we'll apply the force, we need to add the penalty value, which is the last force we'll apply in the element. There we need to apply the penalty value. So for stiffness matrix, first row, first column, and last row, last column. Likewise, the first force and last force will apply the penalty value. We need to add the penalty value, right? So what is the penalty value? Here, F is a given value. It is a fixed. F1 is equals to 0 in the beginning. In a given data, I have given F3 is equals to 0. F2 is applied force at the mid node, that is equals to, so this value F1 is equals to 0, F2 is equals to 100 kilonewton, that is equals to 10 to the power of 5 newton. This is equals to 0. We need to add penalty value at this node number 1 and here, first and last node. First and last node means first node number 1, last node number 3. Add a penalty value for a force number 1 and 3. The global force vector becomes F is equals to F1 plus CA1, F2, F3 plus CA3, where we know that F1 is equals to Q1 is equals to 0, F3 is equals to Q3 is equals to 0 due to fixed, and a penalty value we found 95818 into 10 power of 5 newton per millimeter. We know that C value, just to substitute here, A1 value 0, then this is equals to 0. So then why this one is equals to 0? F1 is also equals to 0. F2 remains same. And then this value becomes F3 is equals to 0 due to fixed point at the third node, and C value is equals to this penalty value, add it here, into 0. A3 is equals to 0, then this value becomes 0 and this is also 0. We have this value is equals to 0, right? So 0, again we got the same, but if we don't, some restricted displacement is given here, means this Q3, so that will not equals to 0. Maybe it is also not equals to 0. Some problems will give like that. Okay, so now again rewrite the equilibrium equation. KQ is equals to F becomes with the penalty value, we have this one, see here, this one. So now we will not take the previous stiffness matrix, we will take this stiffness matrix after applying the penalty value to this equation, and similarly this force vector, Q vector, will remain same. So we have this equilibrium equation. Now press a mod button in a calculator. The calculator model is FX991MS. Three times equation, press it one. Then select a three unknown we have, that is a Q1, Q2 and Q3. Add the value of A1, B1, C1 and D1, A2, B2, C2 and D2, A3, B3, C3 and D3 values into the calculator, and then find the values of Q1, Q2, Q3. So what is that A1, A2? See here, A1, B1, C1, D1, A2, B2, C2, D2, A3, B3, C3, D3. Press it equals button, you will get the value of X is equals to Q1 value, Y is equals to Q2 value, Z is equals to Q3 value. All these values you will get after substituting in the calculator. So solve it, you will get the answer Q1 value, Q2 value and Q3 value, and represent the nodal displacement vector is equals to Q1, Q2, Q3. That Q1 value we have found 7.6988 into 10 power of minus 6. Q2 value is equals to 0.10437. Q3 value is equals to 2.7375 into 10 to the power of minus 6, the units in terms of a mm. We found that displacement of a given bar element at each node of a given problem. Then he has asked to find in a given problem a second bit stress in a each element. We know that the equation as similar to that previous method, sigma e is equals to ee divided by le minus 1 1 qi qi plus 1. How many elements we have? Two elements. E is equals to 1 comma 2. how many nodes we have, 3 nodes, but initial node we will take to define the value of a Q in a stress. So we'll take a first element initial node 1, second element initial node 2, right? We have consider a element number 1, I is equals to 1, E is equals to 1, sigma 1 is equals to E1 L1 minus 1, 1, then Qi becomes 1. Why I is equals to 1, then Qi plus 1 becomes 2. Substitute the value of E and I for a steel material. He has a given that E is equals to 2 into 10 to the power of 5 megapascals and length of the element is 800 mm. Substitute that value and Q1, Q2 value we know that just now we have found here. Substitute these two values here and we get this equation. Now calculate this value. This value is equals to 250. Multiply inside the matrix. We'll get this matrix minus 250, 250, and this is remain same. Now we'll solve this matrix. That is 1 cross 2 into 2 cross 1 matrix. We'll get a 1 cross 1 matrix. Now I'll take this one minus 250 into 7.6988 into 10 to the power of minus 6 here plus 250 into 0.10437. So after resolving this matrix we'll get this. Now calculate this value. This value is equals to 26.09 newton per millimeter square. The stress induced in a element number 1 which is equals to 26.09 newton per millimeter square. Now consider a element number 2. E is equals to 2, I is equals to 2. Element number 2 starts from node number 2 and ends at node number 3. Initial node name is equals to 2. I have taken 2. It name of the element is what? 2. So now stress sigma 2 is equals to E2 divided by L2 minus 1, 1. And I have taken I is equals to 2. Qi becomes Q2. Qi plus 1 becomes Q3. So we have this all values. Now we know that value of the Q2 and Q3, these two values we will take here. Then we'll resolve. After resolving similarly with the previous problem, we'll get it minus 20.873 newton per millimeter square stress is induced in a element number 2. We found the stresses induced in a member, the third bit of a given problem. Supporting reaction at each node means first find out where we need to find out the supporting reaction force at a element. So it is fixed at node number 1, it is fixed at node number 3. That means the supporting reaction where we will get at the node number 1 and 3. So that means the value of force R1 and R3 is equals to question mark. We need to find these two values. We know that the equation in the formula list I have given. Supporting reaction that is equals to Ri is equals to minus C into Qi minus Ai, where I is equals to 1 and 3. Why? Due to fixed end. There we'll get the supporting reaction. At node number 1, reaction force I is equals to 1. Then this equation is yields to R1 minus C Q1. We know that we have found the value of the Q1. This is a calculated value. This is the given value. Given value means it is a fixed at node number 1. A1 is equals to 0. So this calculated value will take from the displacement here at node number 1. So Q1. Take that value Q1 and A1 is equals to 0 from figure. And penalty value we found 95818 into 10 to the power of 5 newton millimeter. All these values are substitute in this equation. We'll get this value C is equals to this, Q1 is equals to this value, and A1 is equals to this. We have represented here after calculating this value, which is equals to R1 minus 7376.836 newton at node number 1, the reaction force. Similarly, we have at node number 3. Reaction force I is equals to 3, R3 is equals to minus C, Q3 minus A3, where Q3 we have found by using the penalty method here. the displacement vector will give you Q3, which is equals to 2.7375 into 10 to the power of minus 6 mm. Substitute here, and at node number 3, it has been fixed A3 is equals to 0. Then penalty value we have enter here in the penalty value minus 95818 into 10 to the power of 5 into Q3 value 2.7375 into 10 to the power of minus 6 minus 0. Calculate this value of a reaction force which is equals to minus 26230.775 Newton negative we got at node number 3. So these are the reaction forces which is occurs due to the application of a force at a midpoint in a given stepped bar element. You can check out here. So we have applied 10 to the power of 5 Newton. Now what we do here, we'll add this two values of the reaction force which is approximately equals to 10 to the power of 5 Newton. Thank you for listening my lecture. I will take in a next video a problem number 2, and which is last problem on this part B of module number 2. I'll solve the problem by using both methods, elimination method and penalty method, for a single problem in the next class, in next video. By using both methods, I'll compare the results. Thank you.